Hey guys, welcome to my channel and welcome to today's video. Today we are going to do a review video of the Natasha Denona Chromium Liquid Eyeshadow. I have had these for a while now, and since they came back in stock, I thought let me do a review of all the shades I have. So I have three shades and I'll let you know my full thoughts on this liquid eyeshadow. I will also show you how I apply all these three shades and how they last and etc etc. So if you guys have been interested in these multi-chrome eyeshadows from the Natasha Denona, then please do continue watching this video. Okay guys, so I purchased three shades of the Natasha Denona Chromium Liquid Eyeshadows. If you have been here for a while, you guys probably know my obsession with multi-chromes, duochromes, liquid eyeshadows, glittery eyeshadows, sparkly eyeshadows. To be specific, I love sparkly, iridescent, multi-chromatic eyeshadows. That's why I have a lot of Devina eyeshadows. I have a lot from her collection. So these are all the multi-chromes, and the white ones which you see are iridescent, glittery, sparkly eyeshadows, which I love. These are my favorite. I also have some Sydney Grace multi-chromes, which I also love. I haven't tried the Cléonard ones yet, but this year I really, really want to try them. So I have been into multi-chrome and duochrome eyeshadows for a while, and these are pretty huge in the indie community. There are a lot of indie brands which have these kind of eyeshadows. Now, if you guys are not familiar with multi-chrome eyeshadows, these are basically eyeshadows which have a lot of dimension and shift to them. There are more than one color to the eyeshadows. Duochromatics will usually have a flip of two shades. In multi-chromatic ones, there will be a flip of many shades, probably 3, 4, 5, maybe even 6 shades. So they look really, really pretty. With these kind of eyeshadows, you don't really have to do much. Just apply one multi-chrome eyeshadow and you're done. You don't really have to do much, because the eyeshadow has so much of reflex in it by itself that you don't really have to do an entire eyeshadow look. The eyeshadow does it for you, and they look so pretty, so reflective on the eyes. So I love them. And my favorite kind of multi-chrome eyeshadows are sparkly ones, which are more sheer, more iridescent, very sparkly. Those are my jam. I just love those kind. I like metallic multi-chrome eyeshadows as well, but they are not my favorite. They are not my go-to. I like the sparkly iridescent ones. Okay, so these Natasha Denona ones are somewhere in between the sparkly and metallic multi-chromes. They are not exactly very sparkly. So I would say these are not my favorite kind of multi-chromes I like, but they are not too metallic either. The fact I like about these are that they are very, very wearable, because they are not overly metallic or they're overly sparkly, although I do wear sparkly multi-chromes very, very often in my regular life. Okay, so that's basically what multi-chrome eyeshadows are. I purchased three shades, and I am pretty happy with the three shades I have purchased. I think my favorite ones, which I really like to wear on a day-to-day basis, is that I can wear anytime, are the shades Dog Bone and Ultraviolet. They are very subtle multi-chrome. If someone is scared to try multi-chromes, or you just want to try and see how they look on you, then probably these are something which you might try for a beginner, because they don't have, you know, that crazy multi-chromatic effect. They have a very subtle, pretty effect, and that makes them very wearable. What I have on my eyes is the shade Scarab, which I think is the most popular multi-chrome. This is the shade Scarab. This has a very, very a reflective, metallic, multi-chromatic effect. I would say out of all the three, this is the most multi-chromatic, most reflective, most metallic one which I have. So this one is not necessarily the most wearable multi-chrome which I have, but I like all three. All the three will have their own occasions. So I think what I will do first is I will show you the application of all of these three shades on my eyes, how I apply and how they look on me, and then we will come back and I'll tell you my thoughts on these multi-chromes. So let's go. I will just show you how I apply these three shades first. So the first one which I'm going to try is the Ultraviolet shade. This is how the packaging looks like. I had to get this shade. It's called Ultraviolet. This is how it looks. I hope you can see the shift. It's so, so beautiful. So this one has a purple and green to blue, pink, light gold shift. Really, really pretty. Now this one, I think I will pair with more of a berry kind of a shade, berry and browns. So I am going to use this palette, Ménage à Moi from Colourpop, and this is how the palette looks like. So this has a lot of mauvey berry tones, so I will apply a little bit of eyeshadow. And the reason I chose this palette is because this already has a mirror. It is going to be very, very convenient. I'm taking this shade Obsession, which is a deeper mauve shade, and apply it all over the basically the crease. So this is going to be my crease color. So I don't have any primer on or anything like that. Okay, and then in the outer we also will use a deeper shade. I will use this color. It's called No Drama. So just a little bit of drama in the outer V. Okay, pretty nice. Now let's go ahead and apply the multi-chrome. Ha ha ha. This multi-chrome will also look really nice with green, light green eyeshadow in the crease. So I'll take a flat brush and quickly just blend the edges. Just blend the edges. I'm not going to blend here. Maybe just a bit of a tap. Okay, so here is the finished makeup look with the ultraviolet multi-chrome. I hope you can tell the shift. There is a slight pink purple in the inner portion of the eyelid, and the shift you can see is a little greenish, light green, light blue kind of a shift towards the outer V. It's very, very subtle, so it may not be that visible, but it's there. Okay, so this is, I would say, the most subtlest one which I have out of the three. And yeah, I really like it. It's very wearable for everyday. But yes, the true multi-chrome lovers who love that very intense metallic multi-chrome, this is not it. But I still don't hate it. It's nice for like wearing any time of the day for a day out. Okay, so that's the first one from Natasha Denona Ultraviolet. Okay guys, let's try the next one. So I'm going to try the next shade, which is called Dog Ben. This was the first one which I had purchased, and I really like the shift in this color. So this is how Dog Ben looks like. It has shifts of like bronze, copper, red and green. It's very, very interesting. I really, really like this color. I hope you can see the shift in here. So let's apply this. Before I apply this, I want to apply a little bit of brown eyeshadow. So I'm using the chocolate eyeshadow by Juvia's, and I will apply this one just slightly in the crease, just adding a little bit of dark brown just at the end of the outer V, just a little bit from the same palette. Okay, now let's apply the liquid eyeshadow. This one has like a coppery pink green vibe. Okay, and again like last time, I'll just blend the edges. Okay, so that's the shade Dog Ben. I really like this shade. I think it's very wearable, and I love the shift of this one. This one also, as you can see, it's not very intense. So if you are looking for intense multi-chromes, again, this may not be what you are looking for. This is also very subtle, very wearable. I love the coppery, bronzy flip to it, and with a little hint of pink and red. And yeah, somehow I feel like this one has a little slightly more shift than the previous one, a little bit more multi-chrome shift. That's what I feel like, but maybe both of them are quite subtle. I still love it for everyday. If you just want to wear a hint of multi-chrome on the eyes, I think this is a good one. Okay, so that one's the shade Dog Ben. Okay, and the last one which I'm trying today is probably the most popular one which is out there, the shade Scarab, which I have got very recently. I was eyeing this shade for so long, and finally I could buy it from Beautylish once Natasha Denona restocked on these eyeshadows. So this is the shade Scarab, which is like a blue, green, gold. It's a stunning color, and the shades of blue and green are also really, really pretty in this. You can see shades of blue, green, gold, olive. It's beautiful. So let's apply this on the eyes. For this, I'm going to use the Boudoir Noir palette from ColourPop. I will use a little bit of this greenish eyeshadows, the olive green and the dark brown in the crease. Applying the olive green now in the crease, just a little bit, just to blend out the eyeshadow, the liquid eyeshadow I mean, and a little bit of depth in the outer V. This also I will not apply too much. The colors are really pigmented in both the palettes. Okay, matte eyeshadow is on. Let's apply Scarab. It also has hints of purple in there, so it's really interesting. All of the colors which I tried had hints of pink and purple. Blend out. Okay, so that's the first eye. So you can see a lot of the gold, green towards here, and a little bit of blue and some olive tones here as well. It's super interesting. This one is, I think, the most reflective of all the three which I tried today. This one is the most multi-chromatic, more intense. It looks more intense, but even though it's the most intense out of the three I tried, it's not unwearable. It's pretty wearable actually. I will wear this very easily on a day out. Okay, so it's official. I think this is the most intense of all the three I tried. I applied a little bit of lower lash line shadow as well, and that is how Scarab looks like on my eyes. Alright guys, so now for my thoughts on these liquid eyeshadows. First of all, these are very, very tiny. Okay, so this is how the packaging of these multichromes look like. The packaging is also very, very stunning. They have that reflective feel to it. So I have kept the packaging. This is how the bottle looks like. Look at how tiny it is. I was shocked when I saw it for the first time. It is so, so tiny. I have the Stila liquid glitter shadows. Okay, so this is how they compare to the Stila ones. Look at the Stila one and this one. This is the Marc Jacobs one which I have. Look at the size of these compared to the Natasha Denona one. So that's why I was a little surprised with how the small these liquid eyeshadows are. Then I saw the packaging for how much product you get. You get 2.5 ml of product or 0.08 fluid ounce, which is very, very little, very tiny amount of product in this liquid eyeshadow for $28. So I think it's a very, very expensive liquid multichrome eyeshadows, but also the multichrome pigments are pretty expensive. They are expensive to make. That's why multichrome eyeshadows are usually a little bit more expensive. This is how the packaging looks like, the small tube of multichrome, just to show you guys. Okay, it's very small. It comes with an applicator as well. The applicator is quite nice. It picks up nice amount of product for like one or two coats, and it has a slight bend to it. It's not very stiff, so it makes the application of the multichrome quite easy. I just wasted a little bit of multichrome. There's so less product in here. These multichromes are good for only 6 months, it says on the box right here. So maybe that's why they have given such less product, because we may not be able to use it up in 6 months. I don't know how long these multichromes will last in the tube, because I have had this Stila Glitter and Glow and the Marc Jacobs one, Stila one for 2 years almost, and the Marc Jacobs one for 1 year. They are brand new, nothing has happened to them. Now you have seen the application. I usually apply just one coat of the multichrome. Sometimes I'll just apply one coat and just blend it out a little bit. Then it is not that metallic. That's how I like to wear it in regular life. I don't like wearing too much of a metallic multichrome in my regular day-to-day life. So I think for that purpose, they work out great. If you want just a subtle multichrome on the eye, then you will really, really enjoy these. They have that subtlety to them. They don't look over the top, especially the shades Ultraviolet and Dogbone. They blend really, really well with the skin, and they don't look too out there. Scarab is a little too multichromatic, it will have its own moments. But I think I like the wearability factor of these multichromes. But if you are a multichrome lover, you know about a lot of other multichromes, you love intense metallic multichromes, then you are not going to like these. These are pretty subtle on the eyes, and even the multichrome shift isn't that much. Only with this scarab shade I found that the multichrome shift is a lot. But with the other two, they are pretty subtle. These liquid eyeshadows will settle on the eyes, so they don't stay tacky. They are very, very comfortable to wear. They don't feel heavy or anything like that. There are some liquid eyeshadows which can, you know, emphasize texture or appear wrinkly. These will not do that. I have tried with single layer and double layer. They do look really nice and smooth, but I do prefer a single layer. That's how I like to wear them. So they settle on the eyes and they are not going to budge that much. They are not completely waterproof, but if you just rub your eyes slightly, they are not going to come off. So they do settle down pretty nicely on the eyes, and long wearing wise also I think they perform pretty well. I have worn them for about 4 to 5 hours and they stayed pretty much the same. So I think the wear time, the longevity, how they look on the eyes, the smoothness, the pigmentation, the shift, they're all pretty nice. These are very nice multichrome eyeshadows. But there are so many other brands, especially indie brands, who have such beautiful multichromes, which they have been doing for a long time. I think they would be a little bit better investment wise, because I think most of them are less expensive than the Natasha Denona ones, and you get a lot of variety in the shades, in the textures. But if you want to try, just try these Natasha Denona multichromes. I don't see a harm in trying them because they are pretty wearable. But yes, do keep this in mind that these are pretty subtle multichromes. These are nowhere near the true multichromes which are available with some indie brands. So yeah, those are my thoughts on these Natasha Denona multichrome eyeshadows. If you decide to pick up any, then do let me know which shade you pick, and if you already have tried, do let me know what you guys think as well. I hope this video was helpful and you liked it. If you liked it and it was helpful, then please don't forget to give this video a thumbs up. And also, if you're watching me for the first time, I really hope you'll consider subscribing to my channel. Any questions, just drop them in the comment section below. I will definitely reply to you guys. Thank you so much for watching today. I will see you again really soon in my next video. Bye.